Hi, I'm Marilyn Pyatt.
And I'm Greg Williams. We are parishioners in St. Luke's Episcopal Church in Altoona. St. Luke, as you probably know, was a healer, and we pray that this parish can do our part in healing our hurting world. We are proud to be an LGBT plus welcoming church and are committed to our vision of passion for God, compassion for people.
But what does that look like? Well, for us, it includes established ministries like our community lunches and sharing our building with AA groups and with the Beacon, which is a program for at-risk youth. It also includes newer foci like our food pantry and creation care, and most recently, preparing for our role in working for God's justice and peace. In this time of COVID, our sanctuary has been a staging ground for our food pantry distribution, as you can see. But let us just tell you about a couple of our other programs.
Creation care isn't just about our charge to care for the earth, but for each other in the process. Our abuse of the world God provided impacts us all, but especially our brothers and sisters of color, who have been the victims of systemic racism that makes it much more likely that they will be even more negatively affected by climate change than the general public. And for many, that their homes are in areas with dangerous pollution that can cause serious health damage. Personally, I spend much of my time working on the Lower Trail. St. Luke's hosts a monthly work party combined with a daily office and a meal. Work, Eat, Pray, as it's called, addresses the practical aspects of removing invasive species in the land around us and replacing them with native plants, while focusing us on the importance of breaking bread with others and worshiping the Creator of everything.
Our local chapter of the Episcopal Peace Fellowship has focused recently on continuing the work begun in the Becoming the Beloved Community course. We meet bi-weekly to study our history and our present role in the sin of racial injustice, and work and pray with an ecumenical group of other alumni of the course who also seek to be better educated and to use our white privilege and faith to address these issues. We're beginning the process of seeking ways to take action, and hopefully by next Lent, we will have lots more to tell you. Thank you for listening.